Hello and welcome back to HWLRadio.com. You're here with your main man, Hollywood. In today's story, we got feds make arrest in multi-million-dollar fake concert scam. And here goes the story. Four men, including one with a history of fraud schemes and an ex-con on parole, were busted Wednesday in a multi-million-dollar plot to dupe investors into bankrolling concert tours by Rihanna, Bruno Mars, and Janet Jackson, according to the feds. The scam came to light in July when a lawyer for the entertainment company that represents Rihanna told the FBI that defendant Quazi Azar was allegedly trying to raise $19.5 million by offering a 22% return on investments in the singer's 2018-2019 tour. After Rihanna's rep confirmed that she hadn't agreed to the tour or authorized Azir to solicit investors, an undercover agent arranged to meet Azir, according to a complaint filed in Central Islip Federal Court. On November 13th, Azir, whose LinkedIn profile claims ties to Sean Diddy Combs, Ice Cube, and Prince, allegedly sent the agent an email seeking a $4 million investment in a one-off concert by Mars being promoted by Rio Vista Universal, an entertainment company in Los Angeles with a website that says it's dedicated to providing quality content and services in publicity, technology, and entertainment. During a meeting in Manhattan the next day, Azir told the agent that Rio Vista executive Mark LaMica was the man and that another Rio Vista exec, James Gainery, had the artist and venue locked up. As long as Gainery raised the money needed to put on the show, court papers say. FBI agent later interviewed Mars' manager and business partner, who both denied that Mars knew Azir or had agreed or even been asked to perform the purported March 2nd concert at Pecto Park in San Diego. 3 months later, Azir again emailed the agent seeking $20 million for a concert tour by Janet Jackson with a guaranteed insured return of 10% per date and 32% return over 16 dates or $6.4 million versus $20 million investment, court papers say. During a subsequent February 20th conference call, Gainer told the agent that LaMica had met with Jackson, who confirmed the tour, and discussed having the Jackson 5 open for her, court papers say. The following week, the agent took part in another conference call during which LaMica allegedly promised him a 35% return, and the agent later wired a $25,000 down payment to a bank account in the name of Untouchable Management Group. On April 7th, the agent met Azir, LaMica, Gainer, and another Rio Vista executive, Kevin Carrick, in Las Vegas, where he signed the contract and agreed to wire nearly $2 million by April 15th. One day before the deadline, the agent called LaMica, who allegedly pressured the agent to wire him $200,000 and claimed that he personally spoke to Janet Jackson and that she personally committed to him that she would do the 2017 JJ concert tour. But FBI agents spoke with both Jackson and her brother and manager, Randy Jackson, who denied having any business dealings with the four men. The complaint against them notes that LaMica has a long history of defrauding investors in similar schemes, including one scam, $1.6 million from the Canadian city of Summerside for a purported Michael Jackson tribute show featuring performances by Beyonce and Usher. The complaint also says Carricker was convicted of grand larceny in California for stealing gold and silver collectible coins from several elderly victims and is on parole after serving 13 years in prison for embezzling $75,000 from his employer, whom he also robbed and stabbed. All four defendants were arrested in California and charged with wire fraud conspiracy. No one immediately returned the phone call to Rio Vista, which is headquartered in a virtual office building in Beverly Hills. So, let this be a lesson. And these motherfuckers right here, nigga, they was something else, wasn't they? These motherfuckers like, nigga, we ain't gonna scam on the bullshit people, nigga. We need the big bucks. Let's scam Janet. They going for people that you know they gonna do some checks on their shit. I guess they thought they was just that damn busy. They like, hold on, man. Shit. Like, we keep getting these calls about concerts, and nigga, we wasn't nowhere near there. Wasn't planning on being there or nothing. Because what they fail to realize is when motherfuckers don't show up for these shows, you got thousands, hundreds of thousands of angry motherfucking, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, of angry motherfucking customers that got tickets, got scammed out of their money, and shit, ain't nothing there. Unless they was just like, shit, we gonna make it seem like this is going on. We ain't gotta sell a ticket or nothing. Nigga, we just gonna beat the motherfucking investor and just come up with the next host. But this goes to show that you need to start double checking on motherfuckers when they saying they got some work for you, or they got a job, they got a gig, or any damn thing. Like, let me make sure everybody's on the same page first. Because as you see, you will be duped. You will be duped out of a million. And sometimes these motherfuckers get away. But that's going to be the show for today. So make sure you go over to hwlradio.com. Download the radio station app. Make sure you check out the sponsors page and shit. I'm out.